In this lesson, we'll see in detail how you can define your database model in the OutSystems platform. We'll create an application that manages purchase orders. Let's go ahead and create the application, call it orders, and let me give it an icon. And you can download this icon from the resources of the video and hit save, and let's create the module for our application. Okay, let's start by defining the entities in our application, and we will start with a client entity. And we're going to add a few attributes to this entity. And let's say that we have a name for the client. We have an address and an email and also a phone number. Okay, as we've discussed in previous lessons, this entity, when we publish the application, this entity will map to a table in the database, and the entity attributes will map to columns on that table in the database. Now, let me just go over here the attributes that we created and set the name as mandatory. This property here, that is mandatory. This one is mandatory. The address I'm also going to set as mandatory, and also the email. And this property, this is basically metadata that is used by the platform for input field validation. We will see further ahead how to validate inputs, but what I want to make clear is that a database constraint is not created for mandatory attributes. Let me also do one other thing, which is quickly go over the data type of the attributes that we created. So a name is by default a text with 50 characters long. An address is also a text with 50 characters long. By the way, let me just change this because I think that we will need more space to write down the address of the client and make it 100 characters long. And an email is also a text. Well, it's not, it's an email. Curious, right? Let me just go and press F1 here on the data type field. So this is the entity attribute properties page. And here on the data type, you see that we have a link to learn more about the types of the entity attributes. And this gives you basically all the data types that you can define in your development environment and the mapping to the several databases that you can use on the OutSystems platform. So for instance, in SQL Server, the email is going to be a varchar 250 characters, and also on MySQL and on Oracle, you have the mappings here. Okay, so we added these attributes to the client entity, but we already had here ID attribute. When you create an entity, an ID attribute is created by default, which is an integer and an auto number. So this means that when we create clients, this identifier is going to be automatically incremented. And this is what is called usually as a primary key. It allows you to uniquely identify a record in the entity, in this case, identify a specific client. In OutSystems, a primary key is also known as an identifier. Okay, so let's create another entity and let's call it product. And also let me add a few attributes to the product, like a name, a description. Products also have a price. And you notice that once I created the attribute price, the platform guessed that this is a currency data type. So the platform tries to guess the data types based on the name of the attributes that you give to those attributes. And let me add one final attribute, which is the quantity in stock. And you'll notice that quantity in stock is cleverly guessed as an integer. Let me also set a couple of these attributes as mandatory. So the product name is mandatory and the product price is also mandatory. Now, before we continue, I want to make sure that I have some data on these entities. So as we did before, we're going to bootstrap data for both of these entities. Let's start with the client. And we're going to right click here, select from the advanced menu, create action to bootstrap data from Excel file. Select the client's Excel. The mapping of the Excel columns to the client attributes is all okay. And let's proceed. And let's do the same for the product. Okay, we're all done. Before we move into the next lesson, let's publish so that this data from these Excel files is bootstrapped in these entities in the database. That's it.